Planners, this is Tina Phillips from A Wild Plan, and this is probably my fifth time trying to record this, mainly because what I'm going to show you today is how to do a color picking project using an app that I found, a free app called Palette Cam. And I know a lot of customers really like to, they want to match their planners, and a lot of designers don't always give out hex codes or don't feel the need to. But if you're making your own, sometimes this will also be helpful because you're sampling things like that. So I'm just going to show you a quick little trick. What I've done here, what you need to do here is just take a screenshot. So say you're wanting to match your planner, and this is your page in GoodNotes. All you need to do is just take a screenshot. And if you're on an iPad Pro, it's the power button and then the up volume button. And you just click that at the same time, and as you can see, it kind of goes down, and then it'll go into your photos if you just leave that alone. Then what I want you to do is just flip out of GoodNotes 5, and as you can see, Palette Cam is this little purple confetti-looking thing. And here's my problem that I have that I'm having to do a screenshot this way. This is actually an iPhone app, but it will install on your iPad. So if you're on your iPad, sometimes you'll be looking at this sideways, but it's such a simple little app. It's really not that big of a deal. All you need to do is go to your photos that you just took that screenshot and just scroll down and select your screenshot and you say choose. And it kind of comes up. And so then you're left with this little spot that basically sits there, and you can like go over areas, and then you just click that green button right there, and it starts to save the colors that you're picking. And you can basically choose from anything. So you can choose these colors, you can choose like the green out of that picture, you can choose, let's see, I had some. My only problem is that it doesn't necessarily take in the whole picture. But this is better than, you know, anything I've seen so far. So what you do, so say you've chosen your colors that you want to match out of that little diskette looking thing right there at the very bottom in the bottom right hand corner. You want to go ahead and click that and then select the color palette. And then you'll see all the little, the hex codes, RGB, but this isn't, you know, that you're going to look at that, so that's fine. And there's different ways to export this out. And what I do is just, I hit that little export button at the top right. And you just want to tell it to copy the info. Okay, so it copies it to your clipboard. So now I want you to get out of Palette Cam, go back into your planner and GoodNotes, and just make a text box and click and hold and hit paste. So all of your hex codes come in. And so all you need to do is just copy and paste each one. Let's zoom in a little bit. And you can delete this little text box after you're done. But when you go into the pen mode, all you need to do is select, this is like the custom pen color, and you have presets, and then you can also do a custom. And here's where you're going to be able to put in those custom hex codes. And you can sit there and type them if you want to and just add it to presets and just keep doing it. I always copy and paste. I'm too lazy. It's writing. That's my other problem, is that it automatically takes you into pen mode. I would love it if I could do custom for text, but it does not let you do custom presets for text. It will allow you to do it for your highlighter. So you have a separate highlighter custom set, and then you have a separate pen custom set. And this is where, like when you're handwriting, this is where it seems to be the most creative, where you can just, let's see, 683, 70, add to presets, and just keep going back there and just type in all your little hex codes pretty easily. But it makes it pretty nice that you can just copy and paste out of a screenshot, and it's exact what you need. And it's super simple. It's a little bit kind of rubber bands and paper clips, but it works. It works. So that's really all I needed to talk about for custom presets and colors, though. So you can keep getting started and playing around with your fonts and handwriting. And I will just talk to you guys later. Thanks. Bye.